Up next on my channel, Italeri's T-34-85, kit number 6585, out now. It is the Russian tank used by the Koreans in the Korean War. Their special edition Korean War model. You can even see the guy driving it is Asian. That is a cool looking tank. I've never done a big Russian tank before. This one's got a lot of stuff. It's got decals for four versions. It's got upgrades that you would normally pay quite a bit of money for. So let's take a look at everything that's in the box. And we thank Model Rectifier Corporation for sending this over. They have it available right now, and I will link down in the description where you can grab yours. But for now, we're going to take a look at the sweet green, the Russian green styrene. I like how that rhymes. Beautiful detail on this. This kit has just enough trees and just enough parts to make it interesting. Nice upper hull detail. Look at the cast texture on that. Beautiful work on that. Excellent mold detail, but yet doesn't have so many trees and parts that you get driven completely out of your mind. Now you're going to get two parts trees that are identical with your length and length tracks. Say that 20 times fast. And all your road wheels, inner and outer, with their hubs integrated. Return rollers, drive wheels, external fuel tank parts. We got very fine molding on these little handles and details. We got extra track pieces. These are the road wheels with tires. They aren't hard to put paint on and paint those rubber tires. And remember, in the real world, when they sprayed these tanks, they sprayed right over the outside of the rubber. As the tank drove, the rubber flexed a little bit and a lot of that paint came off, but usually on the inner ring, unless they had to change a tire out in the field because it chunked off or something, you could see paint on a lot of the rubber. That was extremely common in those pictures. Nice detail here. We got all those cool little etching on the, we got the ends of the fuel tanks, even more fine handles. These are the ends of the tow cables, so you know it's a separate tow cable. Beautiful styrene detail on those tracks. That's for the bottom run, so you can get an idea of how long the tank will be. The T-34s had quite a long straight run along the bottom, and then they just kind of sagged on the top like the Tiger tanks. We've got other parts of the tank. Rear, you can mold this with open hatches or closed hatches. It's going to have some interior detail in the turret, as you can see. Turret rings, again, we've got that gorgeous cast texture, yet it's in plastic. That's going to look lovely. More hatch detail, got a machine gun molded in 1/35, looking lovely. More exquisite little detail. Plenty to bring out with some dry brushing. Then on the final parts tree that's in green, we've got that lovely cast turret. You can see where the plates are welded and where they're cast. Nice detail on the welds. A little bit of ribbling down there. The roll of nickels. Roll of dimes, roll of nickels, whenever you weld. That's what they say makes for a good welder, if they can do that. We got more handles. Extra track pieces for armor. We got our barrel halves. Hatches. We've got interior parts like shells, radio equipment, even a light. Flexible light, all these interior parts. We've got some nice ammo boxes. We've got the mantlet here with its texture on it. Like saying the word texture. Should count how many times. Now, let's switch to the other side of the table, show you some cool stuff you wouldn't normally find in a kit in a second. We also have a set of vinyl style, glueable one-piece tracks. I love when they do this. Keep doing this. I wish Tamiya and all the others, Meng and Dragon, would do this. Include the length and length and a tree of the flexible vinyl for those of us that don't want to spend a month doing tracks. Very nice detail on those. Top and bottom. Not a problem with those at all. Those are set up like that. We've got a piece of rope with a very nice wire texture to it. So that we will use for our tow cables. We got a nice set of decals for the four versions. Got our Korean star. We got all of our numbers on here. Those look great. And in this kit, a full tree of photo etch, grills. We got interior pieces for hatches if you want to mold stuff open. We got little latches in there. Straps. Look at the tiny holes molded into those straps. And a turned metal barrel. Yes, it is a turned metal barrel. So you're not going to have any problems with stuff like that. You don't have to glue a barrel together. All these upgrades right here would run you close to $30 in the aftermarket. They're included in the kit that you'll get from Italeri through Model Rectifier Corporation. Now I'm going to start building mine up and I'll be right back. Alright, well, one of the cool things I like about military kits is after you get past the assembly process, which can sometimes be tedious, the other stuff tends to go pretty quick because you don't end up with a lot. You end up with a main hull and you end up with a turret. You got some road wheels all set up. Now, this one, of course, has the interior that we saw in the little mini slideshow, which shows you could work on the interior here. You could decorate it up. You got the interior of the turret you could do up and leave all the hatches open and all that. I don't ever really do that with mine, so I took those pictures so you could see what that kit involves and all the high detail inside. You can open up all the engine hatches, all the vents, louvers, and all that stuff. You can leave that all open. I have it all sealed up because I just want it as a display model. Now you could attach the fuel tanks. They are the same color as the tank itself, but I'm going to be painting those off to the side to give them a little bit of contrast. So I left the slits open that you have to cut from the inside with your hobby knife, and then you have to drill some holes to fit some small parts on the fenders and stuff like that. And then that is easy enough to do. And then you will glue everything together. It's got a full suspension. You can actually look inside, and in that slideshow through here, you can actually see the springs in there. And if a person wanted to, they could cut those springs short and you could move all of these arms to any position you wanted. So if you wanted to build a diorama and have it going over some stones or some, you know, parts of other vehicles or something, you could articulate those tracks and glue everything into position that way and have a nice looking little diorama piece. You could see it all glued together here. Of course, when you put model glue on that green plastic, it gets a little pale, so it does look a little weird, but you have to remember this is all getting primed and painted. You can see those beautiful photo etch screens. We saw in the parts thing, there's one screen and then there's a guard that goes over the top of that screen to reinforce it. And that bends around the corner and you just bend that gently around like a pencil or a pen, something smooth and round, and then use super glue to glue that in place. Model glue is not going to work on brass. You're going to have to use super glue to hold it in place, or rubber cement, whatever you prefer. We've got our nice exhaust coming out the back. This entire piece can be left open so you can see inside the engine compartment. We got our exhaust. We got a hatch you can leave open. We've even got the torsion spring to hold that open. We've got all kinds of nice little grab handles, vents, side vents, all stuff that you can leave open to look down inside the tank, storage boxes, toolboxes. Up in front here, I'll be mounting some spare tracks like they want. We've got our machine gun mounted. You can see that from the inside, just barely. But you can see the back where the turret mounts in there. You can see underneath. So if you do want to leave it open, you do want to open this whole thing up and super detail it and knock yourselves out, you've got all the ability to do that. Even under the hull is detailed with hatches, rivet marks, all that stuff, and that beautiful cast texture, and then that solid plate on the front. That's even got little mounts on it for wire and winches and cables and everything. So it's quite awesomely detailed. The turret is no different, as you saw from underneath. when we have those pictures. We've got the entire breech and firing mechanism, the entire gunner's mechanism. We've got lifting hooks on the turret. We've got mantlet covers. We got the mantlet itself with its little hole for the machine gun. We've got our nice aluminum barrel. You can use the plastic one, but why would you want to? That is drilled down inside there. So you fill that with black wash or black paint. It's going to look like an open barrel. We've got our hatch, which is completely detailed underneath if you want to mount that open. You got a lot of ways you can go with this. We got our handles on here. We got our equipment for the bustle rack. It's not a bustle rack, but it's a bustle on the back. So the turret looks lovely and all that cast texture. It is multi-piece. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces that make up the turret. And you can see once you get glue on them, they look like they're welded together and all designed. And you could go farther filling it with putty and redoing it. The drive wheels go together easily. I left them all off. I will super glue them on later when I attach the tracks. We got our return roller on there. That glues together nicely. The smoke cans glue together well. Those will mount on the back of the tank. And the fuel tanks and all those little slits I showed you, the spare fuel tanks, those all go together very well. I want to paint them separately, weather them up, and mount them as if they've been replaced or swapped in and out. They don't quite match the paint. We've got our road wheels here. Cut all the most of the tree away so we can work on them. And then we use that nice rope and the ends. I use super glue to attach them. And now we've got some nice tow cables that are very flexible that we can get paint on, get them metallicized, get them decorated, get them attached to the tank. So at this point, I'm going to take the tracks, I'm going to take all my other parts, get them on over to the paint area, get everything primed, get it color painted, start the fading, start the little bit of weathering, and then we'll be back to the bench to work.
Thank you. Thank you.
As you can see, building and weathering a tank is super easy. Don't let the folks online tell you can't do it. Only I know how to do it. It's really easy to do with craft paints and some pre-made washes. You could make your own washes, but those Tamiya washes are so easy to use and put around, and they dry nice and quick and they work very well. You can see the effects on the tracks look lovely. We'll get those underneath the tank. I always like using the vinyl ones. They build up quick. That turret looks awesome. Now I enhance the bottom where you're going to trap more dirt around the bottom ring, and then just a little on the sides. And then you saw me all over the tank once I did the basic weathering with that much lighter brown. That's sort of what a lot of other modelers will use on airbrush and the Tamiya buff color, that light tan color to give an overall dust effects. And that's what I use that brushed on, and then I burnish it with a finger. One of the best modeling tools is a finger when you're using craft paints, because they're non-toxic and they can't harm you or anything. They're water-based. They wash off easy. You can see my hands come out just clean from soap and water. Is go ahead and give the whole tank that buff look, that dusty look, and it's going to look awesome. And we go over the decals with it and everything to bring them down a tone and stuff like that. It works out really, really well with just some basic chipping and weathering effects, some oil drip effects, some gray wash, brown wash, black wash gets in there, does the details. The black wash around the road wheels enhances it, makes it look like it's rubber. The sides, if you spray from the top and the bottom, the sides stay the primer black. They just look like a dirty black rubber tire. And it ends up being all different shades. And it really is so easy to do without having to try to go around and hand paint everything. The steel road wheels, we got dirty on the front, bare steel on the side from rubbing on those steel tracks, where it always just rips them clean, on the return wheels and the drive wheels. So this stuff is super easy to do. Now what I'm going to do is just cut the tracks free, leave the turret off till the very end. I'm going to thread my road wheels on. I'm going to put the tracks through, get the return roller and the drive wheel in there, and those are just going to glue into place. The road wheels just press into place over their holes on everything. It's a friction fit once you have paint on everything. It's a nice tight fit. We're going to attach the turret. It's got two rings here. You see I don't bother painting the inside because you can't see it. And then we will just push it down and turn it into position, and we will have the first Russian-based tank used in Korea that I've ever done on the model show. So I'm going to finish all that. If I decide, I might add some more mud effects. I don't know. If I do, I'll tell you how I did it when we get back to the final. As you can see, Italeri's T-34-85 from the Korean War is a very simple kit to build. It's not complicated. When you see these things at model shows or online or in magazines and they look weathered up like that, it's as easy as to give it a shot. Get out some basic craft paints, the stuff you use for other models that I've shown you over the years, and just start putting it together and have a good time. Build for you, have fun. You can see using the vinyl tracks, they look good. You just press them against each road wheel when you want that sag that you see on the box top. You take each road wheel, you press down on the top of the vinyl track, and you just super glue it to the top of each road wheel. And you get your nice ripples and sags all the way along the top. Looks like you spent 3 days building plastic length and length track. And if you like the length and length track, that is hard to say over and over. If you like that style of hard plastic track, they're in the box. If you feel those are more realistic, those are the ones you can use and enjoy building them. The road wheels and the drive wheels all can be put on after assembly. They go on very well. They friction fit. You didn't even need to glue them on there. The track in the front, the tow cables are included. These nice little grab handles are all over. Look how sweet those decals are. I went right over some of the equipment on the side of the turret, and they fit right in with some decal solvent. It holds it into that textured, like it's painted over the cast turret and all that. So it looks really, really nice. The additional chin or the whisker pieces, the lower chin pieces of that turret match that cast look on the box art, so I didn't bother filling that in whatsoever. I just left it as it was because it looks just like that. We got the mantlet. You can pose the cannon up and down. You could leave all the hatches open on the turret. Look down inside. You can leave the back louvers open down so you can have it look like they're opened up for venting. I love that it includes the photo etch. It includes photo etch if you open the back for the engine compartment. Put a little engine in there. I rusted out the exhaust super easy. Left some oil and grease stains and some exhaust stains on stuff. Did mild chipping, as you saw. Armor models aren't difficult, and they don't have to be, and they can look very realistic with a lot of good times ahead just by using some basic craft paints and having that. I thank Model Rectifier for sending this over. It is awesome. I had no idea it included an upgraded aluminum barrel. Photo etch in the box, that's like 20 bucks off the aftermarket at least. It's all thrown in, and the original parts are there as well that you could use if you wanted. So, highly recommended. This is available right now. I will link down in the description. As always, step out of your comfort zone. Try an armored kit. Try a couple. You're going to enjoy yourself, and you're going to have something different to toss up there. And this is a nice big one and builds up super easy. There's no complicated million parts to it or anything, but yet it comes out nicely detailed. Smile. Build for you. Remember, it's just a hobby. Take a breath. If you bounce your model around, it's not going to kill it as long as you put it together right. And we will see all of you at the next review.